this supposed to happen? Sounds like he destroyed it. Ugh. Stone golem going, yes, awake, my creature. Awake and hear my command. What is wrong here? No! No, stay back! Back! I command you! Father! Yells Colette. Okay. Alright, we gotta... Spells aren't gonna work. But we're still... We're still hasted and everything, so let's... go to town.
With vengeance! Hello there.
Father! You're alive! Oh, thank the gods! Yes, I'm alive, my daughter. Thanks to our kind stranger here. Dora says, Colette! Colette, what has happened? Oh boy, we've got a whole drama going on here. Oh, Dora! Oh, Dora, it was terrible! Jermien says, one of my own creations turned on me, boy. It seems I am not so wise and powerful as I had first thought. Okay, maybe you'll re-examine some of your other... you know, actions and opinions of late. And perhaps I have been foolish in some of my other decisions as well. Dar, boy, if you promise to take care of my daughter and protect her, if you still want her, I'll not stand in the way. Oh, father, are you serious? Thank you. Dar says, indeed. Thank you, Jermien. I shall take excellent care of Colette, you can be sure. Come, my love, let's not waste this chance.
Stand back for justice!
She's busy. Where's Dar? He ran off already? Left? Wait.
You need something, stranger.
My thanks to you, girl, for saving a foolish wizard's life. My daughter is now gone. I think I will leave myself for a while and consider what I have done. The Juggernaut Golem activated. The cowled wizard Jermien used the mimic's blood I brought him to activate his Juggernaut Golem, only to have his creature turn on him. I managed to kill it and save the wizard, for which he was quite thankful. Yes, it didn't turn out the way I thought. I thought we were going to fight a wizard. We ended up saving a wizard from a golem. Oh, he just leaves. Okay. With us free to loot this place as we... Alright, what did he give us? We rested again, right? Yeah, she has her spell. Ilbratha, plus one. This ancient bronze sword is set with six matching bloodstones that was apparently forged for Faerûn the First, a long-dead king of Cormyr. It saw little use and eventually found its way to a favored of the king's guards. Despite the aid of its illusionary magic, that unnamed soldier fell in a later battle, and the sword was lost to brigands or scavengers. Okay, you can cast Mirror Image once a day, which lasts for a turn. Deco plus one, and damage is 1d6 plus one. Very fast, of course. It's a short sword, faster. Speed factor 2. I'm not sure if that's impressive for a short sword or typical, but either way, it's relatively quick compared to most weapons. Well, Yoshimo can use it, but I'm not sure I'd have him use it. 1d6 plus one. Yeah, this is much better. It's a pretty interesting weapon, though. So, I'm putting it in the bag of holding. So, magical weapons. You take this, then. Here.
What do you need? I am skilled in avoidance. Nothing dangerous, I would hope.
A jasper gem and a tiger cowrie shell necklace. We'll just tell them Dar came in and stole it. So they have money for their travels. Haste wore off. Alright, we got scrolls, of course. What you'd expect to find. Power word sleep. Protection from normal weapons and contingency. Sweet. Potion of fire resistance, potion of clarity, and a potion of genius. Yeah, cool. So we know all these spells. It is a good spell. I mean, good potion. These scrolls, I think. Both of us know them. Well, we got to loot the place and we have to fight this guy.
Don't teach my camp, see, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
Time is it? None of us know haste, and I want that on us for this. When we go look for Valygar, that's the only thing left here we haven't really done.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
We're not scattered, I hope. Good. So yeah, we're gonna rest till morning again. Or at least till 8 hours from now? I think that'll be 4 a.m. Was it 8, I think? Right now? I forgot. I think it was 10. So it should be 6 a.m. right now? Oh, 4 a.m.? Okay, never mind.
Butt kicking! For goodness!
By the time I get up there...
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
And by the time I get up there, yeah, the rooster is already not sounding like a crow. I don't know why I said crow. Now, we killed this guy's defender, so he might be on the lookout. If he ever leaves his house or checks up on these people.
My thieving skills will be of little use here. What wealth does a bear drop in the woods?
Poop. It drops the wealth of poop. I'm really just going to put on the protection from evil.
I go.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Because that does last a little while. Hopefully we're not just confronted with the wizard the second we run in here. But let's see. Okay, so we're not.
You require my counsel, yes? I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
$15. Any trap on the door?
Ho there.
Oh.
More cowled ones are their servants, no doubt. By the gods, I swear you'll not live to take me to that damnable sphere.
Oh. I have breached your walls and seek tribute in gold or blood. You choose. I am here on my own, so before you jump to conclusions, I would know your name. My name? My name is Valygar Corthala. I thought you knew this. Watch, he's like not a bad guy at all. That'd be awesome. You do not serve the wizards? Then I have hidden myself so desperately only to be set upon by chance? This is misfortune indeed. You might still be able to help me. A planar sphere appeared suddenly in the slums of Athkatla several weeks ago, which you may have seen. Yeah, I didn't want to mention anything about the wizards. I kind of felt like he would just attack if I did that. My ancestor, the necromancer Levok, built that sphere and disappeared with it over 5 centuries ago. It has not been seen since, until its reappearance. I have no desire to meet my ancestor, and even less desire to help the cowled wizards who believe my body is the only key to enter the sphere, alive or no. His body is the key to enter the sphere? What? Aerie says, oh, so this is why they want your body, to get inside that sphere and take its treasure. We can't support this, Sapphire. Okay, should you just blow it all? You guys, spilling the beans here. Min says, this changes everything. A fellow ranger plunged into peril by evil wizards. Even Boo cringes at what we have been sent to do. Sapphire, this cannot be. They tried to force my cooperation, and I was forced to defend myself and flee. I had hidden away here. Successfully, I thought, until you came. It doesn't seem surprised we're mentioning the wizards now. This one's good. I was hired to apprehend you, but I think I should reconsider. Who are you that I should believe you? How do I know you're not lying to me? Why should you fear this Lavok? The ancestor of yours is certainly dead. I'm not going for this one. That's a good question, too. Well, I'm guessing the answer is no. Pity. I'm interested. No, I'm not going to say that. Okay. Who are you that I should believe you? Who are you that I should believe you? How do I know you are not lying to me? I cannot prove the truth of my words, my lord, but compare my motivations to those of the wizards, and there is more. I am the last of the Corthala line. That may mean little to you, but it means plenty to Lavok. When Lavok left Athkatla in the sphere, he was already many centuries old. Lavok extended his life by stealing the bodies of blood relations. If he yet lives, you can imagine my concern. That's also why my blood may allow entrance to the sphere. Your blood or your body? Maybe they need all his blood. The wizards mentioned nothing of this. No, I'm just giving it away. You did kill two of their number, did you not? Aye, I did. 'Twas no murder, however. They attacked me first. I refused to cooperate with their request, and fled as soon as I was able to withdraw. There is more to this story than I was told. Perhaps you should tell me everything. A planar sphere appeared in the slums of Athkatla weeks ago. My ancestor, the necromancer Lavok, built that sphere as some sort of planar traveling device. Lavok disappeared with the sphere over 5 centuries ago. It has not been seen again until now. I have no desire to meet my ancestor, and even less desire to help the cowled wizards, who seem certain that my body is the only key to the sphere, alive or no. And I say that again. Why should you fear this Lavok? This ancestor of yours is certainly dead. It has been a long time, but for all I know, time may work differently when traveling the plains. As for his immortality, well, my ancestor has extended his life before. Excuse me. But that is a different story. I am the last of the Corthala line, as... Same stuff I said. Okay. The wizards have not been entirely truthful. How do you propose we solve this? My proposal is that we return to the city and enter the sphere. That way I will know if Lavok lives. If he does, we can exterminate his ghoulish existence once and for all. You're more than welcome to whatever lies within the sphere, such as magical treasure and anything else of Lavok's. None of it interests me in the slightest. It seems unlikely that Lavok survived these 500 years. I could be alive. Time, yeah, had a feeling. How is it that you can enter this sphere? This whole story sounds like fantasy. Okay, same, okay. What you suggest sounds interesting, but will the cowled wizards not oppose us? The wizards will not rest until they get inside that sphere, and one cannot hope to stand up to the cowled wizards for long, at least not without steady hands at one's back. Steady hands. What, you mean backup? Very well, join and we shall see what is inside this planar sphere ourselves. That means he's going to join the party. Most excellent. My family swore an oath long ago to kill Lavok should he ever reappear, and perhaps I shall be able to fulfill it. My heartfelt thanks at your offer for aid. Of aid. Yeah, I'm not going to let him in yet. I should probably tell you, before you agree, that I intend to rescue an old friend of mine, Imowen, who has been taken hostage by the cowled wizards. It could be dangerous. There is strength in numbers with you, and if you wish to have my help in exacting a toll against the cowled wizards that stand in your way, you'll hear no complaint from me. Let's be moving, then. More than likely, the cowled wizards will hear of my movements, and the fact that you accompany me soon enough. We shall have to be ready. Jahira says, we'll have to be careful with the cowled wizards now at our heels, but it is a righteous cause, and another companion to stand at our side is always welcome. Min says, be welcome, brother of the woods. Together you and Boo and I shall stride forward to crush all evil in our wake. Woe betide evil!
We'll come back for him. Tell me, Harper, who was who with your parentage? Father the Darthir, Mother the Rivel, or Father Human, Mother Elven? It's always confusing with crossbred mongrels.
She's so pleasant, isn't she?
Two people in love, swine. A rain not likely to soak your parade of scabbed obscenity anytime soon.
Your parade of scabbed obscenity. I love it. I have encountered Valygar. So we can't do this, right? I mean, we could just kill him. But, yeah, I have a feeling that would not be right, first of all. And we'd be helping the cowled wizards unleash something from another dimension or whatever they're looking at. I have encountered Valygar Corthala in his cabin in the Umara Hills, hiding from the cowled wizards who believe that he will enable them to have access to the planar sphere in the slums district of Valcatla through his blood relation to Lavok, the necromancer who created it 500 years ago. Yeah, 5 centuries. Valygar believes that Lavok himself is within the sphere and that he intends to prolong his life through taking the body of a relative as he always has. Valygar's family has sworn to kill Lavok should he ever reappear, and now this is his chance. I have agreed to take Valygar with me to Athkatla and enter the sphere and discover what is within, and kill Lavok should we encounter him. Yeah, but we're not... I'm assuming we can, like, meet back with him here. Valygar's trying to move.
Fleet of foot and all that.
Are we through? I should like to know if we are to continue.
We should split up for now.
As you wish. If you change your mind, I would still like to travel with you. I still think I have much to see in this world.
I will return to my cabin in the hills for now. Well, we could say all right. We'll go there if we need you again, which is where we are. Or I can say that's not possible. Wait right here, which is where we are. All right, we'll go there if we need you again. Can we get to this other stuff here? Am I allowed to take this stuff?
Hi-ya! The tourists love that stuff.
Close the door. Magical spear. And, I think those are +1 arrows. I was just checking out your digs. Not taking anything. Spear +1. Arrow +1. We added it onto there. Wow, done in the Umar Hills for now.
Live by the sword! Living, stand back for justice.
So, are we gonna pay the 10,000? I mean, the 20,000? Or 15,000 to the Galen Bale, I believe is the name. Because I really came out here to kill this guy, who I thought was a wizard, and he's not even. Just sounds like a wizard. Valygar Corthala. Sounds like some kind of wizard. So, I don't want to do this. They're really looking for him, all this stuff. So he really killed the two cowled wizards in self-defense. I think the price was less. Yeah, we might end up having to pay that, because... Oh, crap! I wasn't even paying attention. There's a lot more of them now. Wasted. I think there was one right behind him. Oh no.
Run, Boar, run!
What can I do?
You can destroy these foul things. Holy smite.
Take
the life she gave!
Armored, sharpened, and raring to go!
No mercy for those who oppose us!
I am, meleeing here.
A simple matter.
Says what?
Hey. Oh, did I interrupt that? Oh man.
Fine.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Oops. I think Minsk wants to make friends with the moose.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
Don't teach my moose to... I don't know. Captured by Russian agents.
For goodness!
Let's head back. Because I was really looking at... Yeah. We have some money. Let's see if we can sell some things here really quick.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
We might be set upon by the Cowled Wizards once we get in there, and that may make looking for merchants a little harder. Okay, good. She will buy some stuff. Alright. Plate mail. I'll keep the rest of this stuff for now. I'll keep the contingency. In case we need a contingency. So glad we finally have a potion case now. Keeping the Bill Gerald thingy. All right, now we have even more money. I mean, we're not getting rich out here, but it does help. Let's go to the, the slums. Single rest.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Because we just went 20 hours. And it's 2 a.m. That's gotta be it, yeah.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
I do hope we're not chased around the city. It's gonna be get annoying really quickly. Hail Bernard. We didn't have any trouble getting to. Merchant? Caco Fiend. I definitely need to check this stuff out. Sword of Flame plus one. Wow. Yeah, it'd be nice if we could actually buy this stuff if we didn't have to spend all this money to rescue her. If it'll even work. Okay. We might be going to talk to Galen Bale next episode. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.